fucking stupid and foolish of you to think you can do this. You can't risk it, you never will, don't even try to pursue it. I took the chance, I played the bill, I nearly died for this music. You make me wanna run around pulling my guns out and shit. You're tempting me to run my mouth and call you out on this bitch. I'm ignorant, you gotta be to believe any of this. You need a set your ribs, get pissed and go jump off a bridge. I think I see that sarcasm in the verses I spit. What you think, I just got lucky, didn't work for this shit. Bitch, I've been working at this ever since I was a kid. I played a million empty shows, calling family and friends. Got a person with this abandoned, deserves to get big. Hate to be that person when my verse comes out the kid's lips. Shit, this verse is a kid, this verse is over, I quit. Zion, Charlie Sheen, are your girlfriends 10?
With fucking DMS just shining to my left.
Got Phantom in the rest. Do it down to rep the West. I grew up by drive-bys.
And now I can't stop.
So what the fuck you know about being a gangster? And what the fuck you know about being a stranger? You been doing this, so you know you just talking shit.
as a lynch mob double.
They want blood and they'll kill for it. Drain me and they'll kneel for it. Burn me at the stake, but the devil made them kill for it.
True, you clapped on Bob Dylan's third solo record.
Yeah, I did. It was over in it was in where did we play that festival?
You were in New Orleans or something.
No, that wasn't New Orleans. That was Baltimore. Yeah, he
had a whole mic rig. He just came up and just clapped on stage.
Yeah, pretty, yeah.
No, he said it was very hippie focused. So
right. Yeah, we told him he was faking the folk, so we had to fix that for him. First show we ever played was Virgin Mobile Fest with Bob Dylan, and we got the hotel room key to like the Curls' rooms, and one of the other dudes in the band had like some gnarly diarrhea.
Funny Man or Charlie Sheen shat their pants, I think, one time, and had diarrhea.
Yeah?
Yeah.
On stage?
Yeah.
So like we went in his room, like turned all the water off in his room, like drained all the water out of his toilet, ordered gay porn. Yeah.
I had to keep him busy too while they did.
Yeah, he took him to the store and bought a bunch of ice cream. And then, like, as we were leaving the room, they were like, what are you guys doing on this floor? We're like, we got off on the wrong floor. He comes in, like, this diarrhea splattered all over the toilet. There's no water, so he can't flush it. We hit a camera in there. There's a gay porn playing. And they were just, we played it back to us. And all he hears is, ooh, it stinks. I'm not paying for that. They complained for, like, half an hour. They didn't know there was a camera in there.
So who was this you did this to?
The Curls and Biscuits, our drummer. I think they actually left the gay porn on, though.
I really don't know who it was. Who do you think it is?
They mentioned you.
Mentioned me?
Yes.
Oh. If you have film of someone saying it was me, you might as well just cut it right now.
It was once a dark, lonely summer's eve on the lonely streets of Albuquerque when the Lord called upon six crazy MCs. J-Dub, Charlie C, Johnny Three Tears, the Curls, and the Bulldozer!
Hey, y'all about the homie funny. Sexual like I'm hetero. When I play a bitch like Nintendo, telephone ride in my benzo. Funny as fuck, I should do stand-up. Bust caps at the crowd like I don't give a fuck.
Fuck you,
got a cold ass grill. Hit me on the sidekick and you wanna chill. Hop in the ride, let's roll. I'm a baritone with the voice so low, it'll make your speakers explode. And I'll drop your panties to the flow. Let me bend you over, let me lay you sideways. Hop in the back, girl's Freaky Friday. If you got beef, then you better step up, bitch.
Only the dead ain't none to fuck with.
And I can show you how to hump without making love.
The way you look at me, I can tell that you're a freak.
And I'll be laying in the sun, bottle in a cup.
The way you look at me, I can tell that you're a freak.
Girl, come and swim a pole like tomorrow. Introduce me to your mom, it's Charles. It's Charlie C. Shake your ass to the bass.
Yo, wait till you see my face, hey, bitch.
Put the tight jeans and show your ass crack. My first name gives me an old flashback. I get drunk and do the same old, same old. Change the girls home and call Charlie's angels.
Yo, what you gonna do with the wicked sign?
Gonna lose my mind. Get 30-inch spinners and pin my rhyme. Go back in time. Bitter that night, save Tupac's life. Then pay my fun. Forget it, caught fucking on the Hollywood sign. Got the game on line. I'll have a bottle lead and clap with bites just like a rock. My time's so bad for Rupert Murdoch.
Yeah. I can show you how to hump without making love.
J-Dog, where did that name come from?
It's my initials. And I used to breed bulldogs and stuff like that and sell them. So it's my initials, and that just all kind of fell into place.
I have no idea. It was the first thing that came to my head. I was like, oh, Charlie Scene. Like, okay, cool. Next. And then, what do you guys want to be called? The Curls. Like, pff, gay. Let's fucking run with it.
Some curly hair, I guess.
Three Tears was the name of our first band, myself and a few other guys in the band. And people just called me Johnny Three Tears during that time because I sang in the band. The name of the band was Three Tears. So it developed from that, and then we started this band. And once we started involving masks in it too, we were like, well, let's like see what we could do with names as well. And that was just a natural thing for me to go to that same name I had in our old band for so many years.
People in the band didn't want to be like, yo, the producer. So we changed it to Deuce, you know?
Funny man, because I'm not funny.
Dude, you're fucking hilarious.
Not really. I don't know. No, it came from, it's an old childhood name that I had.
Funny man was, he was named by my brother, actually, because he was so unfunny, because he's like one of those guys who like just starts talking and then you laugh at him and then he starts laughing and you just say, dude, you're fucking funny. But he isn't. I don't know. He's just funny.
Yeah! What's up? What's going on, Tempe? Now, fuck that. I know you guys can get louder than that. Quit bullshit me. Come on. Everyone in the crowd, give that camera a big old finger for me, please. Everybody, come on. All you lames over there just standing like you're badasses, put your fingers up. Give them a fucking finger. Quit being a little bitch. Come on. Yeah. All right. This next song is a fun song. Okay, hold on. The girls is doing today. He's fucking up my shit right here. Oh, sorry, dude. It's all good. Where's my boy J-Dog over here? I need your help, man. Come on. J-Dog, tell him what's up. Get this crowd going.
Come on. See you guys jump up and down with those right motherfucking now.
Jump. Come on.
Jump. 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 California, twice as a go. California, show me love, get buzz, let's go.
Nah, no bullshit. You guys have been one of the best fucking crowds this whole entire tour. This club is small, but you guys are fucking killing it. We never done this shit with the cameras before, so it's even more people on stage with us. So on the count of three, when I say funny, you guys say man. One, two, three, funny! 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 Where you at, funny boy?
Right here. Hold on.
Oh, we got a surprise for him, though, right now.
I want to do something with my main man over here. Where you at,
You guys see Red Jumpsuit Apparatus tonight?
Hey, Pisco, I'm sorry, man.
This is Matt from Red Jumpsuit Apparatus. He's going to get Funny Man drunk before he does his next tune.
All right. Blow, chug, chug, chug.
So what was it like the first time you heard your song on the radio? Where were you at? What was going on?
When I first heard it on the radio, we were on tour. I think we were in Nashville, and that was really cool. I was like, holy crap, we're on the radio. But the most special moment for me was when we were on the radio where I grew up, K-Rock in Los Angeles, because that's the radio station I grew up listening to. That was an occasion that I always, it's stuck in my head, partially because I was with my ex-girlfriend at the time too. And she heard it, and you knew it pissed her off a little, because she like thought I was like a fuck up, and then like she hears us on the radio, and you could tell like she was like, oh, that's good, but you could see that, fuck, they're screwed up. And then of course she was like, hey, you want to be my boyfriend again? I was like, fuck you, bitch, I'm gonna go fuck a bunch of people. No, I'm just kidding. But you know, I was just like, so that made it extra. It was just a spectacular moment for me.
I was at home, and I got a call from my manager that we were gonna be played on K-Rock, which is the local rock station in LA, and I went outside. And I turned the radio on, and it was playing. It was like one of those moments, you know, that's like, I work like my whole life, like trying to do music, and then finally I'm on K-Rock. Like, it actually happened. Like, it was cool, dude. It was really cool.
We were just like, it was just after we got signed, and we were just practicing and playing shows, and it was dope because a lot of our friends in LA were kind of like, holy shit, dude, your song's on the fucking radio, you know, like texting me up, telling me and hitting me up like, dude, I just heard Undead on the radio, blah 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 blah. And it's just dope, like hearing that shit, like your homies in LA hitting you up being like, yo, your shit's on the radio, and they're all stoked about it, you know.
I was on my way to Magic Mountain. I mean, I hate it there, but this girl that I guess I was dating at the time, she talked me into going to Magic Mountain, and I just had like a bottle of vodka with me, like, because you know, you don't want to go there sober. And then it came on the K-Rock, which is our home station, and like I was tripped out, but she kept screaming, like, ah, and I was like, I can't even hear it, like, shut up. She shut up, and they're like, yeah, that's Hollywood Undead, and they talked about us. And then, so I called everyone else in the band, and then he called the Curls, Funny Man did.
I'm gonna be a bitch right now and just be honest, because someone else in the band will say it already.
And the Curls actually started crying.
I was just gonna say, that's why I'm laughing right now.
Tell him what the Curls was doing.
He called me crying, man.
But I actually was, I was emotional, I cried.
I was like, what are you fucking crying about? You've been playing on the radio.
He was crying out of
bitch. Out of happiness.
So then after we called everyone else and said, damn, that was dope, we called the Curls and called them a pussy because he was crying. It was a group effort.
It was like growing up in LA, going to shows, listening to music, hearing all my favorite bands on the radio or not on the radio, whatever. And then actually like 3 years after we started this group, being able to hear our music being played on the station that we listen to all the time or whatever, that's just a great acknowledgement. So yeah, some people would just be like, oh, that's cool, or laugh, or be like, fuck yeah. I was emotional about it. I was happy, but I was still emotional about it. So I'm a bitch, I guess.
Oh,
That's right. Put your hands up with me. Keep that shit up. This song's called City.
Still the evidence, the apples
of police control my dad.
And it's hard at times to ask if you can save my heart for last. And it's hard to face the facts
when the darkness makes it black.
It's not just make believe when they make me take a seat and they put amphetamines
in the air and make me breathe.
So come on and grab your children, look out for burning buildings and villains who villains
are killing by the millions.
Millions of people dying for a lost cause, and now I pray to my nation
destroyed under God.
Scene's gay. He's really gay. I'm not gay. He's gay. So if he says anything, he's gay.
Who's your favorite member of Hollywood Undead?
My favorite member would be DeCurls, probably. Just because, yeah, because without him, I'd be so fucking bored on the road. I'd have no one to fuck with. It would just, honestly just be depressing. Like, yeah, it's DeCurls. I look at him like he's entertaining to watch on stage because I laugh at his stupid stage presence. Laugh at his dumbass name. Yeah, DeCurls is my favorite.
Watch out, dipshit.
Oh, there's a camera here. I'm going to say something funny.
Lee will fuck you up if you talk any more shit.
He doesn't like you.
This reminds me of my high school years. Standing around all the kids while they're all conversating, having a good time, and I'm here all alone. Anybody want an autograph? I always pictured it would be a lot more fun and entertaining, and I would always picture myself doing fun shit, but turns out I'm just a fucking loser. I'm sure if you guys had to pick just by the name Funny Man would have seemed pretty appealing. If you know that you'd be walking around laughing, the camera would be shaking, you have to put on image stabilizer because you'd be giggling so hard, you would shake the camera. else the footage would be unusable. Look at that fucking idiot. Get out of here, you dumbass.
Where? Oh, that guy just walked by.
Who has to follow him around? Sucks on. You're texting your buddies right now like, dude, worst day ever. I'll tell you later. Meet me at the bar.
Which bar are you going to?
I'm not inviting you. I'm talking at what?
Hey, what bar are you going to? Hey, oh, yeah.
Who's following him around, dude? Whoever's following him around has probably got a hard on. Sponsor?
It helps the vocal cords.
Tasty.
I love doing Paradise Lost probably the most. But that one's different for me too because I have to do all the vocals and it gets trying because it's hard. It's a hard song to actually sing.
We came up with this whole drum interlude, like breakdown bridge for the song Paradise Lost. And now we play it, and it's this whole thing that really brings a better side to the live aspect. So that's my favorite song to play live.
Put them up with me.
It makes us, it makes us, hate us, it gave us nothing but nothing.
years. We love you guys. We love all you guys. I recognize most of you from last time we were out here. You guys are just as ugly as I fucking remembered you. I'm kidding. Joking. You guys are fucking attractive. Honestly, I love you guys so fucking much that I'm gonna dedicate this next song to every single one of you. This song is so fucking special to me. This song I wrote after something that changed my life forever. I wrote this song after I caught somebody fucking my little sister in my mom's fucking station wagon. On my mom's fucking birthday. On my little sister's fucking period. And honestly, I was so fucking pissed off that I went home and I wrote a fucking song. And honestly, since that day, I still haven't found it in my heart to forgive Johnny Three Tears for fucking doing that.
Fuck my sister too. I was hurting.
Honestly, if you guys are pissed off, then please sing along. I wrote this little song called Black Dahlia about fucking him, that piece of shit. You motherfucker! Put your hands up. Everybody.
I'm sorry, Charlie.
I fucking hate you, Johnny! Louder last time.
I used to be
Thank you.
All right, we got a couple more for you guys. You guys actually have to forgive me. My voice is gone. We've been playing for 5 weeks, 6 weeks. I'm just trying to rock and roll for people that I love. If that's a crime, if there's a pig here, you come arrest me right now. I'm gonna try it as hard as I have for you.
Fuck the police, man. This didn't do it all.
Fuck the police. Are we gonna get this party started again?
Albuquerque.
That's not enough.
We're until 2.
I need more booze. I want booze.
Starting to annoy
you. Ditched him.
Yeah, I ditched him.
Lee, I'll never ditch you, dude.
Well, Lee, dude, my boy, he's a nice guy. He's not as fucking tight as you. I just say he's got a beard and shit. Yeah. My guy's like a, my fucking camera boy's like a vegan or some shit.
Just in case your boss watches, I say you can't film me anymore tonight unless you have a beard in your hand, okay? It's true, Lee.
You may.
There it goes. And...
That's good. You don't even need to brush your teeth now.
Where's Charlie Seen?
Right here.
Do you know that I'm wearing your glasses?
Yeah, it's fine.
It's cool?
Can I suck your tits?
Sure.
Hey.
Ow!
I think I just puked my soul out.
People are different when they drink.
No, it's good because my face looks good from a lot of angles, so if you get them all.
Yeah, if you had three angles at once, yeah, on that beautiful little face.
Do you want a kiss on film?
Fuck it.
Thought about it, didn't.
Everybody can clearly see that we're very comfortable with homosexuality. I'm not gay, but I do not mind gays. It's living West Hollywood, man. Fuck it. Right, Alex?
So you're saying George has a nice dick?
George, look.
Nice. Never sing a dick!
Why doesn't George sing that song?
He really I just want to George.
He really does. He loves. He actually does love to show his weenie.
Yeah. It's just funny.
Do me a fucking favor and let me hear just the ladies scream on the count of three. One, two, three! Let me hear just the fellas on the count of three. One, two, three. Ladies. Fellas. Ladies. Fellas. Ladies. Fellas. Ladies. Fellas. Ladies. Fellas. Ladies. Fellas. Everybody fucking scream. Follow my lead. see you next
good
time.
Night. Thank you.
Thank you, guys.
So you guys know, and I hope you put this in DVD. DeCurls is a dildo. He's the dumbest member of our band. I hate him. Back me up on that cam.
He owns a pocket pussy.
He owns a pocket pussy? He's such a dork. I don't get it. He doesn't have anything to offer the world at all. Please, if nothing else goes on the DVD, please put that on there. Please.
I'm gonna film you while you film me.
Hollywood, we love.
is amazing because they're in your face. And who can beat that? No one.
No one can say the things that they say.
Fucking raw.
Never.
Only them.
Never.
What's your favorite lyric?
Lyric? Oh, fuck.
Shit.
40's popping, panty dropping.
I've got a baritone voice so low. It'll make your speakers explode. And I'll drop your panties to the floor.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's it.
That's it?
There's a lot to choose from, so we can keep going. You want us to?
I want some more, yeah.
You all want right. some more?
All right, ready?
Let's do California.
All right. Ready? Coming, all right, ready?
Ready to go.
Coming straight out of Cali.
What?
818 Valley.
What?
323 fucking Horse Nut Alley. And from Highland to Clayton, all these bitches are hating. Because the shit that we're saying is the shit that they're playing. We don't make it, we'll take it. If it real, then we'll fake it. Open your mouth and I'll break it. Don't give a fuck if you hate it. We're looking for the six chicks, down with the six sticks. Rolling on a deck, getting buzzed, it's ridiculous. Horny like a sickness, quick as the quickness. Pussy like it's business, working like it's fitness. Listen while I spit this, gaming all these bitches. Now I'm gonna hit this and fucking tell I'm dickless.
Yeah.
Agree?
Yeah.
I've been an Undead fan for like 6 years. I can't even do that. It makes me sad.
Introduce yourselves, Hollywood Undead number one fans.
I'm Lauren. I'm April. And we're obviously their number one fans.
Did you guys think of any questions for me that you'd like to ask the band?
I had one. What was it? Oh, if they can do a whole bunch of cover songs, I want to know what they would actually choose.
What would I like to play?
Yeah.
And even if it's beyond my capability to actually play?
Yeah.
Excuse me, motherfucker.
Hi, Johnny.
Hi. I would want to play all of After the Gold Rush by Neil Young. Some Captain Beefheart.
Honestly, I'm not very a big cover person on cover songs. I would say Charlie Sheen is, that's more his area.
If it's cheesy or cliche to say even, but like Beastie Boys, I'd love to do like a Nine Inch Nails song.
Thank you for this opportunity. We love you.
Yeah, and
we'll be seeing you again, don't worry.
Yeah.